Hi, this demonstration will show you how to create an application that can be used in a help desk scenario to allow agents to handle calls. This type of application allows calls to be routed invisibly to one agent or a group of agents in conference. It also allows a supervisor to silently monitor the progress of a call or to coach the agent without the inbound caller hearing the conversation. My name is John Clarkson. I'll conduct the demonstration. I'm a technical writer for the Lync product group. This slide shows what I'll cover in this demonstration. I'll start by providing a bit of information about back-to-back calls, then I'll explain how the computers in the demonstration and their Lync clients are set up. I'll run the sample application so you can see how it works. I'll walk through the code in the sample application, and finally I'll point to some other sources for information if you want more information about back-to-back calls. So let's start with some background on back-to-back calls. There are two different scenarios supported by the back-to-back call class in UCMA 4, incoming idle and click to call. We're dealing with incoming idle in this demonstration. Take a look at this next slide and you'll see the call flow for an incoming idle back-to-back call. In the incoming idle scenario, a back-to-back agent application waits for an inbound call. You can imagine a customer with a question. The plan is that when the inbound call comes in, the agent application will complete an outgoing call to a human agent, imagine a customer support technician, or a conference with multiple agents. While the agent application is waiting for the inbound call from the customer, the outbound call to the human agent is in the idle state, meaning the call is not yet established. Note that there are three actors here: Bob, who is our customer on the inbound call to the application, the back-to-back agent, which is our application, and Carl, the employee who receives the outbound call from the application. I'll use the names Bob, Carl, and Agent throughout the demonstration to refer to the various actors in this scenario. So, in step one, the customer calls in on the inbound call with a question to ask. In steps two and three, the agent application makes an outbound call to Carl, and the application negotiates a handoff of the inbound call from the customer. In steps four and five, the handoff to Carl is complete, and you see that the SIP messages get one channel through the agent application, while the media goes directly between Carl and Bob. Next, I want to explain how I set up the demonstration. There are three computers involved, and it might get a little disorienting, so I'll try to make it clear before I start what all the pieces are. Bob, our inbound call customer, is represented by a Lync 2010 client named John Clarkson 8 and is running on a Windows 7 laptop. The agent application connects to a Lync 2013 client named John Clarkson 7, and the application is running in Visual Studio 2012 on a Windows Server 2008 R2 desktop. And Carl, our customer support employee who receives the outbound call and talks to Bob, is represented by a Lync 2010 client named John Clarkson 9 running on a Windows 7 desktop. All these computers have a wired connection to a Lync server domain. So now it's time to demonstrate the application, so I'll switch to the computer running our agent application. I'm connected to it using remote desktop. And here it is. You see the Lync 2013 client, and over to the left here, Visual Studio 2012. Take a look at references. The single reference I added to the application is to the UCMA 4 version of the RTC.collaboration DLL. And then I added four keys to the app.config file. First of all, user URI 1 is the Lync client sign-in address on the application computer. That's our agent application. Server FQDN 1 simply points to your Lync server computer. Username 1 is the username from that first key, the user URI 1. It's just the username. And finally, remote user URI 1 is Carl, our customer support technician. Note that Bob, the customer on the inbound call, doesn't get a key because, of course, why? Because of, we don't know who he is. The application is designed to take a call from anybody. We don't know who's calling in. No key in the app config file. There are two code files. B2B call contains the code specific to this demonstration application, and I also added UCMA sample helper, which is a library containing startup code used in many of the sample applications that ship with UCMA 4, and I'll show you here how you can get that file. I will open Windows Explorer, go to the Program Files folder, look for Microsoft UCMA 4, open up SDK, open up Core, Sample Applications, Quick Starts, and then there's a Common folder, and in that folder is the UCMA Sample Helper file. So now I'll start the application. It's a console application, and it's getting a lot of information about usernames and server FQDN and so on and so forth from the app config file, but it still wants a password from me, so I'll type that in. And pretty soon here, it's going to be set up and waiting for the inbound call from the customer. And there it is. So now I'm going to go to the laptop and make a call to John Clarkson 7, which is the Lync client connected to the UCMA application we were just looking at. So we're going to go over to the laptop here. And this is our customer calling in. So I want to call John Clarkson 7. I'll select that contact card, click call. And pretty quickly here, you'll notice that the listings, contact listings for John Clarkson 8 and John Clarkson 9 now indicate that they're in a call. John Clarkson 8 is Carl, the customer support technician, and John Clarkson 9 is the inbound customer call from this computer. So now I'm going to step back a few seconds and show you what's been happening on the back-to-back agent computer. You'll see the agent making the outbound call to Carl. And pretty soon here we'll see the toast on the back-to-back agent computer because we're connected using remote desktop. It doesn't really apply to us, but we can still see it just because we're connected. So there's the toast, and we'll go back to Carl's computer. He accepts the call. And you see the contact card here that identifies the other party in the call as the Lync client on the back-to-back agent application computer. You can also see the little level indicator here in the contact card that shows the audio levels in the conversation. Now I'll end the call. We'll go back to the back-to-back agent computer, and I'll give you a code walkthrough. First of all, at the top of the B2B call file, we declare variables. There's objects for the inbound and outbound conversation. There's objects for the back-to-back call and the inbound and outbound legs and wait handles. And then down in the run method, which is where most of the real important stuff happens, we create and establish the user endpoint instance, and most of that happens in the UCMA sample helper file. We register the delegate to be invoked when the incoming call arrives, create a conversation object and settings for the outgoing call to our customer agent. And this is created after the incoming call arrives. And we create an audio-video call object for the outgoing call and register a handler for the state changed event on the outgoing call. And the next important thing I want to take a look at is how we handle the incoming call from the customer. That's the call received handler. And in the call received handler, an audio-video call object is required when creating a back-to-back call object for the inbound call. And you'll see we register for the state changed event, and we create a new conversation object and settings for the inbound call, and we create the back-to-back call object. And then there's two state changed event handlers, one for the inbound call leg and the other one for the outbound call leg. First of all, the event handler for the incoming, for the inbound call, you see here we're deregistering for events, and we call the begin terminate method, and the same thing on the state change event handler for the outbound call leg. Deregister for events and call the begin terminate method. So now for other resources, there's two things I want to show you. First of all, there's a code sample available, which we'll get back to in a second. There's also an article that provides more information on all fronts than I did in this demonstration. And it's under Lync 2010 in technical articles. If you scroll down to the bottom of that section, you'll see a title, Using UCMA 3 Back-to-Back Call. And of course, that discovers excuse me, that discusses UCMA 3, but the code is the same as the code I used in this application, so it applies to UCMA 4 perfectly fine, written by my colleague Mark Parker. There's lots more detail here on the code and conceptual background of back-to-back calls. To get the sample application, just go to code.msdn.microsoft.com, type in back-to-back call. It'll take you to the sample application, which you can download, which contains all the code that was used in this demonstration. Thank you very much.